Cave or a cell is like a hosting area,
a bit
wide
and big, connected with a little one. This is where Amba Bishoy lived here almost like 100 years. We are under the floor all the time. Here is the surface of the floor up there. Of this hole.
So it's a natural cave?
Natural cave. So the whole wall is from the mountains. It's been craved to let him allow to live by. And we already received an icon, a very ancient one, telling a story of Amba Bishoy usually hanging his head with a rope and hanging this rope up there in this hole to keep him awake. If he's fallen asleep, the rope can pull him back to continue him awake, to continue praying. Man of prayer, lived almost like 100 years around, and made a thousand of monks from all over the world came to be with him in this way. Do you mind to see the refectory?
Please.
Yeah. Yeah. How is a thousand of those monks came over to live with him in this place? And This cave and the refectory as well is an ancient places from the 4th century until today. This is a refectory which is telling the story of the life of those monks who scattered living in the desert, everyone in his cell, and comes only to pray together, afterward to eat some kind of agave meal, all of them together while the abbot is sitting and one of the elders is reading for them from the Bible to keep them engaged with the word of God instead of just talking in any other ways. The refectory and the cell are an ancient spot from the 4th century. We continue in the style of the caves in the deserts until the 6th century. In the 6th century, a big abbot to the life of the Coptic Church named Pachomius came with the red swords from Upper Egypt, telling the story of building what they call it a monastery. It wasn't a monastery, the word before, but the word of the monastery started to be coming up to the life of the monastic order from the 6th century. The monastery is a product of the 6th century. Can you see the monastery now?
Dr. Tadda. Tadda.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
You know the way.
This is one of the recent photos for Amba Bishoy. The just recent one, but telling one of the miracles that he met Jesus Christ twice. One of the first meeting with him, he was offering him kind of service while he is walking, like a poor man walking in the desert. And while he is walking in the desert, asking him, does anybody serve you? He said, no. So he brought some kind of water in a jar and started to wash his food. And while he washing the food, he noticed the cross sign there. So he cried for everybody saying, Jesus was here. And please for this water. So Jesus wanted to go to need another meeting, appointment for his people to be meet. That none of them got such kind of credit except for sure again. He is the one who accepted to carry him on his shoulder to go to see him in a faraway point where he assigned him. And then he deserved to see Jesus twice. So we call him in our traditional life in the church the beloved saint Jesus Christ. So I'm sure he is the core of the monastic order in this place. By his monastic cell has been started in the 4th century. The monastery, which we are going to visit now, it's a kind of like a new building, has been started in the 6th century. New building, according to the history. This church is one of the product has been started by some Syrian monks lived here.
That's true. The word
magnificence word came up. Syria at that time as well, but the church is going, it's kind of like a very precious, anxious style of art which has been designed by some Syrian people who lived in this place where they put the languages all around here. You can see how the language of the Syrian has been surrounding the wall, as well their icons here in the wood, as well as reflecting some verses from the Bible on the frescoes from the Syrian language, as you can see here it is above there. Syrian people lived in this place almost 3 ancient, so 4th, 6th, and 8th, until a big miracle has been happened, which was reflected in this icon, telling a story of Saint Mary came to meet an old and poor monk named Ioannis Kama in this one, and brought to him 3 golden dinars from heaven and said to him, Jesus wants to have a place in this land. Here is a deposit, and gave him the 3 golden dinars. was something astonishing, actually, because what can I do with the dinars in such a kind of land and desert? So anyway, he started to walk in the place and took to reach this space, found some Syrian people are living by themselves here around. He asked them, is this okay if we can be together? They came together and they spent some years. While he passed away, they left to him his body with this marble stone as the story of Anbiya Yahya Kama in this place. Since the 8th century, Anbiya Yahya Kama body is here, which is a blessing for us, actually, with this kind of like a stone given in the Coptic language by his disciples, telling the story of Anbiya Yahya Kama, how he started to be here. Why, when he came here, he said, since this is a fulfillment of the promise that God sent, so let's walk till the place is Monastery of St. Mary, called Suryan, because given the credit for the Syrian people who lived behind us or before us.
There was a Papa Ioannis here?
Yeah. Amba Yehnis Kama. Yeah, here is the translation actually.
Papa
Ioannis. Bravo.
Kamanosu.
Bravo. Excellent. This Coptic one?
Yeah, I'm Greek.
Wow, how nice. How many letters do you use the Coptic into Greek?
You have some extra. You have a few extras.
The difference are seven.
The difference are seven, but it's
different extra.
But also, the he you pronounce differently, shu, and the he you pronounce differently.
Lovely.
Abba Ioannis.
But the Papa's is here.
Yeah, that's true.
Papa Ioannis, Kamenosu, and here it says, Ομοούσιος, which is what we say in our prayers.
Okay.
Μήνυμα Θεού.
Yeah, true. Bravo.
No, it's beautiful. It's so beautiful.
Yeah. It has been made by the Syrian monks and the Copts people who came with Anbiya Yahya Kama while they delivered the body
Ambiya has come about in Israel since the 8th century until today. He is the precious stone of since the 8th century until today. So this is why we call the place the promise that has been made by him to St. Mary. So this is St. Mary Monastery, full cement because of that.
Also, you have an amazing picture of
Galactophorus,
which is the one that gives the
meaning. But let me tell you something about this man. The other icon is telling a very big miracle, which story didn't happen in the 8th century, 4th century. This one happened in the 8th century, this one happened in the 4th century. So I'm going to show you it was here, but his smell was spreading all over the world. So it's kind of like attracting a big apple from Syria named Mark from Suryani, for sure you know the name, a Syrian apple, Mark from Suryani. So he said, well, let's see and meet Amber Bashur. So he took the boat by the Mediterranean Sea, arrived to Alexandria, walked from Alexandria to here with a stick in his hand to help him during this sand. When he arrived here, they're telling him, Amber Bashur is like a big man, like a great one. It's kind of decency if you can leave your stick outside. So he left the stick outside and went up and showing this cell for like some days as he tells. And when he went out, he forgot to take the stick. But God didn't forget. He asked the tree, the stick, to be turned to be a tree, to give him fruits for over 1700 years until today. We're going to see now. Because kind of like witness for this meeting happened between the two abbots, one from Syria and the other from Egypt, came together in the land of Deir Suryan. So why not if we can just give a kind of example that God blessed this one and make this kind of like a tree turn it from a stick to be something like beautiful. This is beautiful. Let's start with the door. The door is one of the very antique historical one which has been started in the 7th century by the Syrian people. They try to reflect the idea of the Christianity from their underground to understanding in a rose, goes from up to down. So you use the ivory from the animal's teeth and beat it with wood in order to make to reflect this kind of history. Yes, that's true. And started with, when Jesus started the life of the Christianity, started with his disciples and Saint Mary. But after he ascending heaven, the cross being the symbol of the Christianity, the logo, but wasn't clear enough in the second generation. In the third generation, the cross started to be seen well. In the fifth century, everybody on the earth started to believe the Christianity. So why the cross getting solid, clear, and unified, and one all over the scene, as you can see. Out of sudden, developing the cross from the second to the third to the fifth, here was a different symbol. The same thing can lead any
Indian
one? Since when?
Since all the time.
All the time? Like any kind of clue? Hitler does have any kind of thing?
Yes, Hitler took it from the English.
Bravo.
Yeah, but he took this one, not this one. This is the original.
Yeah, all right, bravo. And there's some kind of derivation for this to be using for a symbol of his patterns, isn't it?
Yes, that's why he lost, because he did the other way around.
Well, actually, this is the point. Yeah. You don't know that.
Yeah. Sure.
Thank you, sir. Anyway, the people who made this one, they said, would be like an enemy would come out to change the mentality and the procedure and the blessing of the cross. In order to be one and solid, to be broken, to be little, and to be continue broken until we reach to this chaos situation, which is referring to the many denominations, many churches, many gods sometimes, without any kind of like, no more kind of like community, or to be kind of like harmony, to be together as before. So anyway, the door will be ending up by this situation, they said no. It will be another layer. In the last, will be cross in the middle when Jesus comes up from heaven to collect back his people who is the seventh lead in the cross, which he started in the beginning. Who will continue to the end will take them up to his kingdom.
the door of prophecy, as we call it, is something like very precious, very ancient one. And in spite of like four monasteries in this valley, Abu Ma'ar, Amr al-Shuy, Suryan, and Baramos, but only we got such a kind of blessing for having this door because of the Syrian people who came and lived here for a while. When people, the Syrian people came, they made their own culture on the drawing and the icons. When the Copts came after the Syrian, they made different culture. So they kind of like polished the frescoes and made a new layer on the place. When the Copts been by themselves, there is another new culture. We got used kind of like help from Leiden University in Holland to help us for restoring all the ancient places here. And they said, well, every part of the layers of the church, columns and frescoes, has three layers. So this is layer number two. Yeah. We already removed number one and we put it in the museum behind us. And this layer is number two as well.
Do you know from which century?
Yes. This is referring to the 8th century. And here is the idea of the effect of the third one, which is, you can see, the orange broken area, yeah, referring to the third layer. Every layer of the church and every column and every painting has three different layers, which referring to three cultures that passed through this year. Still today, since 40 years ago, we try to restore as much as possible to get out the stone out of, to see what is the different, what is behind them in everywhere. It's very hard work and lots of time. Like as very quick example, if you can see this marble stone here, the column one, the one here, this marble one just came out like 3 months ago, and given like kind of like evidence from the 7th century until today, kept with such a kind of beautiful view, as well as the colors of the top, is continue given all these ancient years without any kind of change. Just some months ago, we cleaned it up from the same style of this color to reach to this one. Look how beautiful it is. With the color of the top of them, as well as the marble one. All these years, from the 8th century until today, it's being covered. So we need a lots of work. Yeah? The same one.
Same here, same here. Do you think there's one behind you?
Is this true? This is what he said?
Yeah. Well, sure,
make it. This one is, this rest is just a little, some much covered. This one. You see the big part of the frames, which is then called this vessel. So we put this up and continue it up, and we found all these beautiful kind of places, as you can see. It's a very beautiful view of heaven and the miracle and the angels. And we get used to use this one on this level, as if this is the artificial one, on the last one.
Ah, yes.
But when this damage happened,
you found the rest.
Yeah, and we found this beautiful one.
You see, sometimes damage can help.
Yes, it's true. Yeah, this is the gift from God.
Yes.
The other one says, Sarek, it is so
bad. This is the cover that we get used to, and use this one while we are trying to to correct this damage which happened. We found out all this beautiful icon of the Van Pukrator.
Amazing. On the other hand, it's the pronunciation.
That's true. The word, the letters. See, sir, how is the Syrian people, they left the art in the wall. They wrote some kind of like words and letters. So we need to clean it up as much as we can in order to reach the original every icon of those. Some here, some there. But still, all this damage, it should be fixed well until to reach this place. Church is really very rich, lots of high pay all over its place in the world. And we need to see the tree, isn't it?
Yes.